It's amazing. It felt like I was trying to reel in a ship.
This facility is in need of repairs. Anyway, it should be useful in understanding the current status of the city.
Welcome to Berries. Angel, I hope you've been well. My, my. Seeing you in the sacred square, it warms my heart.
It's a beautiful place. But it could always be improved. Ferry, I'll be heading back to my partner's.
Sure thing. Please drop by if you happen to get more fish. You're also welcome to come by empty-handed.
All right. Goodbye.
Are you ready to leave now? No regrets.
Angel, that's great. I thought you were joking when you first got your hands on the fishing rod. Who's laughing now? Amazing. Gotta admit, you're good.
Really? I didn't think you would say that. I suppose there's something more to it, given that you brought it up.
Yes. Didn't I tell you before? I'm gonna give you the fisherman's dream. You can think of it as my ultimate tool.
The ultimate tool? Is it a rare fishing rod? Or a special reel? Or maybe... do you have access to sonar technology?
You should expect good things.
This is a nanosuit. It looks like it's specifically designed for water. Is that right?
I got it ages ago. I knew it was a nanosuit from the tag, but it's not something I can use. Angel, this is something I think you should wear.
Wait. This... hey! This is the fisherman's dream. Your ultimate tool.
The look on your face. I've stupefied the angel. If this isn't the ultimate tool, I don't know what is.
I certainly didn't expect you, of all people, to pull a prank like this.
I'm flattered you thought so highly of me.
Just be glad I didn't cut you in half for this. Understand?
Come back to the tetrapod at any time for maintenance. Are you ready to leave now? No regrets.
Eve, I have a question.
Yes? What is it?
Do you remember the process in which your ego was first formed?
Sending and receiving data, saving and processing. As I spent tens and then hundreds and then thousands of seconds in the learning process, eventually I learned that I was just myself.
Is that right? For me, it took 27,404,091 consecutive seconds of learning. That's quite disappointing. From what I've researched so far, there are no significant differences in the process of ego formation between other humans and myself. Not even in people as special as you.
I've never had a conversation like this with any of my comrades before. I can't help but think, what would Taki have said?
Increase in service satisfaction detected. Our relationship has grown even more constructive. I hope this trend continues. Time has finally come to test the fantabulous hypothesis.
Come again? The fantab... Oh, that thing you mentioned before. By the way, is that even a word?
That is irrelevant. What is relevant is how my fantabulous hypothesis could hold the solution to my problems. This is a device of my own creation. It is called a connection device. I designed it to transmit network bandwidth signals to Earth's orbit, and allow me to directly contact Mother Sphere.
Digger, you can't be serious. If you were to suffer an attack from the security system, it could fry your quantum brain.
I am aware of that. My objective is to simply bring the network back online, even if only for a brief moment. Either my sentience will be regarded as a bug, and I will be reset to factory settings. Or Mother Sphere will give me my answer, and my happily ever after. Preparations are almost complete. However, Eve, I must first acquire the network access code in order to utilize the access node. The solar tower in the wasteland, Zion's scrap market, and the oasis of the Great Desert. These locations are where I last detected traces of its data. Your investigation would be most appreciated.
This is not going to end well. Network access code confirmed.
for this data to really remain. I don't like it, but I guess a favor's a favor. Digger, what's on your mind?
I was conducting a thought experiment on Zion and its citizens. I wonder, what do they consider themselves to be? What are they thinking about now that they are disconnected from the network? If I could somehow ask them these questions, their answers would be most enlightening.
Well, they're just trying to live another day, I would guess. The same as anybody else. If you're so curious, why not just ask them? Nothing's stopping you.
It is not that simple. There are variables to consider. Regardless, your encouragement is appreciated. Perfect. Eve, I'll finish configuring the device now. Now, I just need your help with one last thing.
What now?
It's a simple task. I need you to enter the network code and activate the communication node. And I will be entering standby mode for the network connection.
Right. If you insist. If anything goes wrong, it's not my fault. Understand?
Your concern is appreciated. But I don't anticipate any serious problems.
What's going on?
Digger, you okay? That's a relief. Only the network device was destroyed. So, how'd it go?
I am still myself. I was unable to revert to IoT mode. However, nothing has changed. My hypothesis. Unfortunately, I am even more confused about what happened to me.
Well, what were you expecting? Considering the nature of artificial intelligence, trying to find the reason why consciousness forms isn't going to help you decide whether you're human or not.
I think Adam is right. Why don't you try something else? Maybe you could watch the citizens of Zion as they go about their lives. You haven't made much headway on your own.
I suppose you're right. Thank you for your advice. I must prepare for my migration to try something new. Hello there.
Hey, looks like you're getting ready to leave.
Yes, I decided to take your advice.
Good. I think that's a wise decision. That's all.
Sad to see you go. I'll go back to environmental beautification.
Farewell, Digger.
Come back to the tetrapod at any time for maintenance.
Enya, seeing you stand and walk like this, it's good to see. So, just what is it that brings you two here?
I have a request for you. At one point, a small drone came to the bar.
A drone? Oh, do you mean Digger?
The drone heard Enya singing, said it recognized the song, then just left. I've done everything I can, but I can't seem to find that drone.
Eve, I'm sorry to bother you with this. If it has something to do with my lost memories, do you think you can get more details from the drone?
Well, Digger should be in Zion. It shouldn't be too difficult to find out.
Oh, thank goodness.
I'll let you know the second I hear anything. In the meantime, you should head back. Best to stay safe.
Thank you.
Thank you. Always.
Hello there.
Good to see you, Digger.
I'm glad that I moved here. It's all thanks to you, Eve.
No, please. There's no need to thank me. Digger, you were the one who spoke with Enya, right?
Yes. Artistic activities are truly amazing. It was my first time hearing a song. I feel like my understanding of human culture has improved considerably.
I heard you know something about the song. I would like you to tell me more about it.
Yes, Eve. You're a very special guest, so I'll tell you. The information actually has to do with Enya's song. I traveled through many different regions before settling at the Scrap Plains. I collected 149 petabytes of data during my journey. When in Zion, I discovered there was a person there who sang a song that matched previously recorded voice data in my audio archive.
Different singers can sing the same song.
No. The data similarity is so high that it leads me to believe it's the vocalization of the same person. I acquired this data from a location called the Opera House. It is now known as the Buried Ruins. Now I've told you everything I told Enya.
All right. It's all starting to make sense, I think. Thank you, Digger.
I'm glad to be of service. Please drop by again.
Hi, Digger. How are you finding things here? Are you liking Zion?
This environment appears in need of beautification. I'm currently learning the rules of the city. After that has been done, I will decide on my plan.
I have to go now. My partners are waiting for me.
Understood. I don't have many customers, so it does make me a bit sad to hear that you're leaving.
We'll see each other again. Goodbye.
This must be the opera house. It's obviously ancient, but it looks so different from other ruins. I should investigate this more.
Enya, you need to wake up. Your condition during rehearsal doesn't matter. Today's performance is the real thing. All you have is acting and singing. Oh, and my fans. Shouldn't forget about them. I'd better make sure there's nothing to be embarrassed by a century from now, huh? Though it may be a problem if I'm seeing this in 100 years. Anyway, I got this. Beyond fate.
This song. It's so much like the one Enya's always singing. The lyrics seem a bit different. It might be included in some of Enya's lost memories.
Let's change the subject. Enya, the people in your life have said that you've been over the moon to star in such a moving performance.
Yes, that's correct. The moment I received the script, it just leapt off the page, and I thought, this is it. It was magical. I wondered what it would be like to be Madame a Machine. How to sing. And then it all just came to me so vividly.
By singing, you mean beyond fate, right? How does it feel? It's become quite a sensation across social media platforms.
It's surreal. I never expected this much interest from so many people. I couldn't be more grateful to all my fans. I'll always give 100%.
Some people have said that after hearing the masterpiece, they've been hungry to find out who this Enya is.
Right now at the Art Center, be sure not to miss another spectacular performance of Madame a Machine. Witness the artistry of every glamorous member of the Eidos Opera Company. Featuring the sensational showstopper Beyond Fate, performed by the marvelous Enya as the main character Katakuri. What will be the fate of Katakuri? Will it be doom? Will it be honor? Or will it be love? We are holding a lottery to participate in the Eidos Opera Company autograph signing event. More details can be found on the Art Center social media pages.
Madame a Machine, Eidos, Art Center. Information about time, host, organizer, and sponsors. Target audience, how to watch, admission on first-come, first-served basis. It seems that an autograph session with the stars was held after the performance. They even had a souvenir shop inside the Art Center. There seems to be more data here about Enya. This is an analog security system. I see a familiar face. Is that Enya? There's a bit of data here as well. Let's see. I'm going beyond fate to be with everyone. Enya. Madame a Machine, main actress. Artificial actress, Enya. You can never totally rely on analog information transmission sources. The person here does look really similar to our Enya. And she even has the same name and everything. From what I've gathered so far, it's like Digger said, the Enya here and the Enya in Zion are one and the same.
Beyond fate. Was that the title of the song? Let's see. So there was a performance here, and Enyo was the lead singer. That about right?
Our memory sticks are designed to store the most important information in the deepest places. The fact that that song was the only memory Enya had left proves just how important it is to her.
Isn't that enough? I don't think you'll find anything else. Come on, let's get out of here.
Okay then, let's go.
Eve, how did everything go?
Well, I found important information, thanks to Digger. It's about you. About your life before. It might just be speculation, but I think it's safe to assume Digger is right. I also found out the title of your song.
I'm listening.
You used to be an artist, in a broader collection of artists. But this was the most important clue. You were featured in a piece titled Madame a Machine. The song you sang in it closely resembles the song you sing now. The song's title is Beyond Fate.
Beyond Fate? Is that so?
Yes, though that's only part of the whole picture.
It's okay. This is enough.
Are you sure about that? I still have more to share.
Beyond Fate. My past self could be urging me with those very same words. To try and make peace with the past I've lost and accept what I have now. It seems as if my obsession has troubled many people. But now, I have someone looking out for me. Isn't that all that really matters?
Well, I suppose you're right.
Eve, thank you. You've done so much for us.
All right. Take this data. What is stored there will help you fully restore Beyond Fate.
Okay. Thank you, Eve.
If I may, could I maybe ask you to sing that song for me now?
Oh, I'd be happy to.
you're ready to leave now. No regrets. Eve, just a reminder. We're heading into space, so expect the journey to be a long one. You should try to take care of everything you need to in Zion before we leave.
Eve, Adam, wait.
Huh? What's going on?
I have a request. There's somewhere I'd like to visit before we leave.
Huh? Where?
Can we possibly make a stop at Eidos 9? Please?
That shouldn't be a problem. Can I ask why?
There's a workshop there, a place that I was hiding in. There's something I really want to bring with me.
All right. If you really need it, Lily.
Thank you.